Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. So today what I'm going to be talking about is the Besame Cosmetics Cake Mascara. If you guys are coming from my Lucille Ball x Besame Cosmetics review, hello, welcome. If you are coming here on your own volition and you haven't seen that video, by all means, check it out. I'll put a link down below in the description, and I'll also put a little card up there at the top of the screen. This is going to be a review on how the cake mascara performs and if it lives up to all of the hype that I hear around it. So this is my cake mascara. It is quite small. I would say it measures maybe around 2 inches just by eyeballing it. So this is my hand and this is the little tin. So it's kind of small, pretty small, and I already have small hands in general. Inside, I got the actual cake itself and a little applicator brush for mascara. The applicator brush, it is very tiny. It's probably half of my finger, I would say. And I got tiny fingers. Like, don't let the nails fool you. I have tiny fingers. So it's about half of my finger. So it's very, very, very tiny. You're probably wondering how you would even use this to apply mascara, but there is a way how to do it. The actual cake itself is this little thing right here. I have been using it, so if it looks a little ugly, I'm sorry, but that's basically what the cake looks like. It is activated with water, and the actual size of the cake is about this big if we're comparing it to the size of my hand. The way the cake mascara performs is very similar to the way water-activated body paint is. You would just add your water and create a paste, and then you would apply that to your skin. It's very similar to that. So it's very similar to water activated eyeliner and water activated body paint. The only difference is that this is cosmetic and it goes like near your eyes and your general facial area. Now, I'm going to break down how this product works for each of the things that they advertise it works for. So Besame advertises that you can use this cake mascara as like brow product, as eyeliner, and as mascara, obviously. So let's just start with its namesake, mascara. If you weren't aware, cake mascara is basically what was used before tube mascara was popular. The old Hollywood stars would use cake mascara on the set of their movies. A big person that would use cake mascara would be Lucille Ball. Actually, if you go to the Max Factor Museum, I believe it's in California, you can actually see all of her beauty products that she would use, and one of them was a Max Factor cake mascara. So it's actually pretty cool. Now, for mascara, I will say that it is a bit hard to use, especially if you've never used a kind of product like this before. I know I never used a product like this before ever in my life, so it definitely took a couple of tries for me to figure out the consistency needed to make good mascara. So what you typically need to do is add a small amount of water to the cake, and then using the little applicator that is included with it, you would basically scrub it back and forth like this, like it was like a little toothbrush, until you make a nice hearty paste. You don't want the paste to be too watery, and you don't want it to be too thick. If you have it too thick, you'll have clumpy lashes. If it's too thin, you just basically have like watery eyelashes, and we don't want that either. So you kind of have to play around with the product to kind of figure out the consistency that you like. Some people like a little bit more of a thicker paste, and then some people may like a thinner paste. It just depends what you prefer. No matter what your consistency is, you do have to let each coat dry. So if you go in and you scrub your little applicator, which is very tiny, and you put it on your eyes and you apply one coat, you have to wait for that coat to dry. Trust me, you have to wait for that coat to dry. If you do not wait for that coat to dry and you keep adding more coats on top of it, the coats underneath will not dry quickly, and then you're more prone to transferring the product all over your face, as I very miserably learned in one makeup look that I did. So definitely be very careful and let each coat dry in between. Otherwise, you're gonna be dealing with something very terrible afterwards. I would also recommend you test it out on a day where you're not going anywhere important, because it's very easy to mess up with this, especially on the first couple of tries. But overall for me, I found that 3 coats was the optimum amount for me to get the type of lift that I want. Today, I just curled my lashes like I normally do, and I applied 3 coats of mascara to my eyelashes, and I let each coat dry in between. You're definitely not gonna get a super dramatic falsies type of lash. You're gonna get a very kind of natural looking lash. So I don't even know if you can even see the lift of my lashes because I do have this very thick eyeliner, but you get a very natural type of eyelashes, a very kind of natural type of eyelash. So if you're not wearing any like eyeliner and you're just like a mascara queen and that's all you like to wear, it actually looks very nice and looks very pretty, I would say. It looks very soft. But if you're looking for like a very kind of falsies type of lash, you're not gonna get this with this product. It definitely gives it a nice soft look to the lash, but you can use it with falsies. I have used it with falsies to blend my real lashes with my fake lashes, and I find that it works just as well. So just a couple of little points as the mascara. I personally enjoy using it as mascara because a lot of the time I don't really care for my eyelashes to look super dramatic, because most of the time I'm wearing dark or heavy makeup anyway, so the lashes don't really matter. I just kind of care that they're coated so it kind of matches the rest of the look. So that's what I think about the mascara option of this. Do I think it works pretty well? Yeah, it does. Now as for eyeliner. Now as eyeliner, I think it works probably better as eyeliner than it does as mascara. It is water activated, so you can make your little eyeliner paste and then you can actually go a little thicker because it's eyeliner and you want it to glide and look nice, and you're not gonna get clumpiness because it's eyeliner and you're gonna be using like a nice little detail brush. So you would just basically take your little detail brush. Let us pretend that this little applicator is my brush, even though we know it's not. You're just gonna kind of create a paste this way. And then once you have enough product on your brush, don't overload your brush, obviously, because then it won't apply nicely. And then you can create these really pretty wings that are varying in size. I picked this kind of, I guess you could say, like a medium sized wing, I would say. And I got a really nice matte finish on the wings themselves. Again, you don't want it to be too watery, or otherwise you're gonna get like really light coats of product on your lids. And you're gonna have to apply more product to get it very, very dark. But if you get a nice paste from the very beginning, you're not gonna have that problem. It does dry very, very quickly. So if you're the type of person who is afraid that they're gonna get your stuff to transfer, you don't really have to worry about that too much if you're using this as like eyeliner. And of course, if you let it dry in between each coat. This is the main thing I'm gonna be repeating a lot in this video, is to let the product dry in between coats and you're not gonna have any trouble. Now, the only, I guess, problem I could see when I was using this product is that if you take a long time to do your eyeliner or to do your mascara, the cake dries quite fast. So you kind of have to keep going and re-wetting the cake if you work very slowly, which could be a nuisance for some people, which is why I'm mentioning it. But for me, it's not really a big deal. I usually have like a little spray bottle of water. So I just spray a little bit of water and I just reactivate the cake again. So it's not a very big deal for me personally. I think it works really well as eyeliner, especially if you like a matte finish. I don't think I've really found a matte liner that looks truly, truly matte. And this actually, I think, looks really, really good on my eyes today. Now, as I guess you could say brow pomade or brow product, you can actually use the little tool it comes with to kind of draw out or fill in your brows. I personally don't like to use it because I like a particular precision with how I like my brows to be. Now, I have very full brows, as you can see, if I do not take care of them, if I do not wax them, thread them, do whatever it is I have to do to them, they will turn into tiny caterpillars and I will have one eyebrow. So I have a lot of eyebrows, basically what I'm saying. So typically the most I do for my brows is just fill in the little tail ends of my eyebrow. And a lot of the times I don't even do that because I have too much eyebrow. So usually that's the extent of my usage with this product. So if you want to know how it works on someone with really sparse brows, I'm not the best person to ask because I do not have that problem. So typically what I do is I fill in the end using a thin brush, similar to the brush that I would use for my eyeliner. And then with a spoolie, I would take the spoolie and then just kind of blend it together in this sort of fashion. And then that's it. I don't really do anything else to my brows. But I will say that this cake mascara does come in two other colors. It comes in a kind of light deep purple. I don't even think that makes sense, but it comes in like a purple color. And it also comes in a brown. So if you prefer a brown eyeliner or a brown mascara or a brown brow filling product, you might enjoy that better than the black one. But since my hair color and my brow color and generally the hair that grows out of my body tends to lean more dark brown to black, this worked pretty well for me. As for the price of this product, for the tin, the cake, and the little applicator tool, you're gonna be paying around $25. If you're just gonna be buying the cake itself, it's $20. So it's not that bad, I would say. You typically just pay $5 for the case and the applicator, and just pay $20 just for the constant refills. But what I can notice from this product is that this is gonna last me such a significant amount of time, because I've done my makeup over and over and over again over the past week or so using this product to kind of really get an understanding of how it works. And I've barely made a dent in the product itself. Like, you can actually see, I'm gonna take the product out of the tin so I can show you. So you guys can see that I've just barely nicked the logo right off. I haven't even made like a hole in it. So, and that's from like consistent use over the course of a week or a week and a half-ish. So I can see this product lasting a significant amount of time. So will you have to replace your mascaras every 3 months? Absolutely not. You'll probably have this for about a year. And from what I've read from other people and their reviews, their product lasts about a year, which is great. $25 for a product that you don't have to replace until you literally finish it, because it is super hygienic, because literally the product dries quickly. Sign me up. Because that's probably the only thing that I hate about tube mascara. It is very convenient because you don't have to worry about re-wetting the product or anything, and it comes with its applicator on a nice long wand, but it does have the tendency of getting gross very quickly because it is a wet environment and bacteria like that. So I spend a lot more money replacing my mascara, my regular tube mascara, every 3 months, as opposed to just buying one of these for the entire year. So for an average estimate, I pay like around $10 for a tube of mascara. So in 6 months, I've already spent $20. And in a year, I've spent like around maybe $40 or $60, depending on how quickly the mascara rancifies or goes bad. So I'm paying anywhere between like $50 to $100 for mascara tubes within a year. And this is just $25. So I feel like this is gonna make a very nice addition to my makeup collection in regards to saving money. But like I did say, this does require a little bit of finagling. So if you're willing to give it a try, I will be putting the link down below in the description if you want to check it out. But since this is a very kind of slightly more expensive product, I would recommend trying out some water-based eyeliners or some water-based body paint so you guys can see if you like that kind of makeup at all, because some people don't like water-based paint makeup. So I'm just gonna say it is a little bit expensive to try out like a water-based paint or water-based eyeliner to see if you like it. And if you kind of like the way that works, can try it out. I personally enjoy it. I'm going to keep using the product. I have no reason why I shouldn't use the product. Literally the only downside that I can think of is the little bit of a learning curve that happens when you're learning a new thing, and the fact that it dries too quickly. But that's actually pretty great because it dries quickly, so it doesn't give it a chance for like bacteria to grow. But at this point, I'm just rambling. So that's basically my review on the Besame Cosmetics Cake Mascara. If you guys want to see a tutorial of how I personally use this product, let me know in the comments below. But that pretty much wraps up the video. Like always, take care of yourselves, so wash your hands, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye guys.